You're listening to the NFL Draft Bible Podcast Network, part of Sports Illustrated, giving you daily NFL Draft, Dynasty, and Devy Fantasy Football podcasts.
Class is in session. Welcome into the draft seminar presented by Sports Illustrated's NFL Draft Bible Podcast Network. I'm your host, Matt Hicks, the FF Educator, joined as always by my co-host, John Lobb, the Gridiron Scholar. And John, I'm excited about this episode. This is one of my running back sleepers in this year's class. It's Larry Rountree, the third out of Mizzou.
Matt, he's one of my favorite runners in the SEC that no one talks about. He's had a very nice four-year career in a great conference, and his team around him has really fallen apart since Drew Locke left campus. In high school, he was a three-star recruit by Rivals. He was the number 31 prospect in the state of North Carolina. As a senior, he ran for over 1,100 yards. He had 10 kick returns for 338 yards, and he returned one of those for a touchdown. He walks on to Missouri, and as a true freshman in 2017, he was one of the best in the SEC and nation. He rambled for 703 yards with 6 touchdowns. He was named All-SEC Freshman Team All-Purpose Return Specialist. So immediately got on to my college fantasy football radar. He broke out as a sophomore, Matt. 1,216 yards and 11 touchdowns in the SEC. He was SEC Academic Honor Roll. And then the Tigers offense, without Drew Locke, they really, really did not get it together in 2019. Larry came back in 2020, and basically he was the entire offense. He was all SEC second team, folks. Larry Rountree had a tremendous 2020 season, 972 rushing yards and 14 touchdowns. He concluded his Tigers career second all time in rushing yards. Only quarterback Brad Smith had more yards on the ground than Larry Rountree. Matt, what a great career. Really have enjoyed watching him. What's your film analysis say of Larry Rountree?
Yeah, John, I like the film review. And now I want to point out, my fantasy football projection on him is still a taxi squad stash. He's somebody who at the next level, some things are going to have to fall his way. But he's somebody I'm going to have on my taxi squads. My actual taxi squads. I'm going to be getting Larry Rountree because it starts, John, here with his strength. He's an aggressive runner. He seeks out contact. He always falls forward. He keeps those legs churning until the end of the play. He's never afraid to hit the hole hard. And we're talking about, again, we're playing in the SEC, a four-year running back in the SEC. I mean, he hits the hole against Alabama just as hard as he hits it against Florida. Just as hard as when he gets his yearly, you know, matchup against Vanderbilt. and it doesn't hurt as bad to hit the hole. So his strength is great. His contact balance follows him in that way. So I really like that. I think he's got really good vision, John. I think he's patient, but not too patient behind the line of scrimmage. He waits for his holes to open, but he's still aggressive. He's very good at finding tight space and in squeezing in between small gaps. And I think he does really well. You think I'm describing a power guy, somebody who lives just between the tackles, but he runs off tackle really well also. And I think it's because of that vision. He's able to see those gaps open up on the field. Now, one thing that's going to help him at the NFL level, he's a good pass blocker. That's going to help him get on the field, stay on an NFL roster, and hang around for a little while. He picks up blitzes well. When he's in pass pro, he's not sitting there on the back of his heels waiting to get popped. He goes out, and he's aggressive. He meets that defender, and he protects his quarterback, and he's explosive. He's not the fastest guy. Certainly not if you look at that 40 time, but there's bursts of speed that get him to the second level of the field. Now, he's not going to break off the big play after he hits that second level of the field, but he is somebody who could get you 10 to 15 yards at a time. So Larry Rountree will probably find himself as the power back in a running back by committee at the next level in the NFL. But John, we talk about this all the time. Day three, undrafted running backs, they find fantasy football relevancy when they find themselves in the right place at the right time. You're always one or two injuries away from relevancy as long as you are on an NFL roster for fantasy football purposes. So with all that being said, John, why don't we flip on the tape, look a little deeper here at Larry Rountree.
Look forward to it.
All right, as always, provided by Brandon Lejeune, Devy Deep Dive on YouTube and Twitter. And John, we're going to see this first play right here off the tackle. He's patient. He puts his shoulders down, and he takes on this LSU defender. We're going to see it again here. There's a little bit of explosiveness, John. I mean, he's not going to, you know, he's not going to be the quickest guy off the line of scrimmage, but he does well. Look at it. He's going to get to the second level of the field. He's going to take that hit. He's going to fall forward.
Absolutely. He's playing against the LSU defense. He's in one of the toughest conferences, one of the toughest divisions in the hardest conference in the nation. And you do see power and vision here, but you definitely don't see that explosive deep speed.
And you could see, I mean, he's got loose hips. You know, he does have a subtleness to the way that he engages with defenders. And I think, John, the way he takes hits is really, he doesn't get squared up a lot. And that's that, you know, those extra couple yards, those can add up. That's that extra effort and that durability that's going to help him at the next level.
You do not want to get popped on a consistent basis as a running back. And I do think there's an actual skill. Some running backs are able to avoid big head-on collisions. If you don't believe me, just watch Franco Harris of the Steelers in the 70s and why he stayed around in the NFL for so long. And Larry Rountree, you don't see him get squared up by defensive players very often.
John, talk to me about how his production profile lines up with what you're looking for your running back prospects.
5'10", 216, Matt. He has the size of an NFL back, and he's coming from the most prodigious conference in the nation. So when the season ended, my model liked him when I plugged in his career numbers. Over 3,700 career rushing yards, 4,000 yards from scrimmage. He averaged 5 yards per carry. But I'll put that into context. This is not the Alabama offensive line or the LSU ground game. He's running at Missouri. So 5 yards is respectable there. 47 career receptions and 40 touchdowns. So I liked him. Plugged him into his last season. Over 1,000 yards from scrimmage and a 27% scrimmage yards dominator. I really liked him, and I liked the film and games study. However, he goes to Senior Bowl week, and I was excited again. The reports coming out of Mobile, Alabama, were very positive on Larry Rountree. Some of the clips that I could find were positive. He didn't play that much in the game, didn't really get many opportunities. But, Matt, then he had his pro day, and my balloon was a little bit burst. He ran the 40 in 4.70. Let me repeat that again. 4.70. Short shuttle. 4.47, which actually isn't that bad. And his three-cone drill was 6.96. So you have this short, you have this big power back with explosion and agility and decent lateral movement, but almost no long speed. Like, I don't think at the NFL level he could pop it for 25 yards. I just think the linebackers and the safeties are way too fast. They catch up with him. I think he has a role because he's tough. He's physical. He does reach top speed quickly. He just can't accelerate very fast for a long period of time. I think, unfortunately, because of his limited athletic ability, a taxi squad stash is the perfect grade for Larry Rountree.
All right, there you have it. Larry Rountree, the third out of Missouri. Thanks for listening to this episode of the Draft Seminar. If you're watching, please make sure you give it a like. If you're listening, make sure you're subscribed.